A major European airline has returned to the skies, but exactly what post-pandemic travel will look like is still very much up in the air. Experts are warning expect lengthy international check-ins, and pre-flight health checks could also become as vital as our passports.
Coming into land at London's Luton Airport, Wizz Air, the first major European airline to resume passenger flights despite bans on non-essential travel.
I can't see that Wizz Air is going to have a lot of customers. But on the other hand, maybe there is first mover advantages.
The aviation industry has been one of the hardest hit by COVID-19, with passenger planes sitting idle on tarmacs across the globe. So what will post-pandemic travel look like? According to aviation experts, there'll be less carriers, less flights, higher prices, and check-ins up to 4 hours.
Health issues are going to be as important as your passport and your visa. It'll be hard to imagine what flying looks like without people wearing masks and maybe even gowns.
Low-cost carrier Ryanair is set to introduce compulsory face masks and temperature checks for all passengers. With the virus still spreading rapidly through communities, many are nervous about getting too close to other people.
We're going to move to even more contactless check-in, I think. Check in online before you get to the airport, present your health certificate online, those sorts of things, and drop your bag off somewhere quite remote.
Once on the plane, social distancing measures will remain in force.
If you actually put the people 2 metres apart on an aeroplane, you've probably got a load factor. You've probably only got about 30% of the number of people.
Which means ticket prices will inevitably go up.
Airlines returning to the skies is one thing, but convincing the public it's safe to do so is another. A new survey by the International Air Transport Association found 40% of travellers say it'll be 6 months or longer before they feel comfortable jumping back on a plane.
While government bailouts are helping, they can only last so long. Mr. Charlton believes one way to save the beleaguered industry is to allow international mergers of airlines.
Now's the time, I think, to come back and to reimagine and re-engineer and maybe even redefine how international aviation works.
In London, Sophie Walsh, Nine News.